Why can't he have his own day? Why can't Jesus have his own birthday? Why his birthday gotta be coupled up with Santa Claus? Oh, it's to make you forget anything. If it is the month of his birthday, it's to get you so consumed up with buying gifts, wrapping gifts, doing this, doing that. You forget about the real reason of the season anyway. Satan, Santa Claus. Look at the word. S-A-N-T-A-S-A-T-A-N. Same word. And we got to get off of this kick. We so afraid. We so accustomed to just going along with the world. God says come from amongst them. We scared to come from amongst them. Why? Because they made us them. We live just like the European. I'm a black woman reading the Greek Bible, speaking a Queen's language. Go figure. If that ain't confusing enough, what is? You'll never get this religion thing right. You'll never figure out who, what, why, where, and when it come to Christ, because you got to decipher all the nonsense, from your history. Don't look in your past. If I'm a preacher, if I'm a teacher, that's the first place I'm going to take you from the beginning to figure out why the end or why the state is the present way that it is. You, it just didn't happen this way. People just don't become mad, angry, disenchantized from the world. Like, God, we forming our own cultures. We making all these other things up, and we doing all this other stuff when it's already written for us in the Bible what's supposed to be ours, what feasts we supposed to be serving, how we supposed to be living. And again, like I said, even in the Bible, when Christ came and said what he said, that should have been enough. That's enough for me. But obviously, Paul, who said he a Roman one day and a Jew the next day, he had a lot of input in the New Testament. Okay, if it's God, it's God. But there's a lot of things in the New Testament that try to discredit the Old Testament. I'm picking up on that as well. Even in the New Testament, it tells you to follow God's commandments. That's something we don't want to do. Even Christ followed God's commandments. But we, Christ got down on his head and bowed. He sweat blood. He prayed. He looked up to heaven. He prayed. He gave thanks over his food. Most everything Christ did and doing, we should be mimicking that instead of what people told us to do in the Bible. Just look at what Christ did. They're going to find a way to make you serve other gods. And we so caught up in it. And I said, Kwanzaa is the closest thing to Hanukkah. Those two, I could believe and relate. I'm looking at them two side by side. I did a post on both of them. Look at these holidays. What you would know is Christmas is nothing like those two. Christmas is set apart by itself. I even said they take the name of Christ. Christ, C-H-R-I-S-T, and put mass on the back of it. Christmas. They change it. Oh, it's not Christmas now. Christmas. It's Christmas. But when you take the words apart, you got Christ and you got mass. That's their signature all over the word of Christ. To me, I think it's mockery that they would even put Christmas and Christmas and name a holiday Christmas when we trying to celebrate his birthday, and he don't need no holiday named after him. He the savior of the world. What he doing with a holiday after him? And if it's going to be a holiday, why it ain't the resurrection day? Or why it ain't his birthday? You can keep believing it if you want. You can keep believing it if you want. I'm trying to tell you, it's some truth here, people. But just look at the word. Look at the word. And that's it. That just say, Satan, stop. Stop, Satan. Satan, stop. Just so, Satan, stop. I ran outside, got this thing from in front of my door. I said, oh, hell no. I'm not inviting Satan in my house. Yeah, we play around with the little hats. We got a Christmas tree up in there. My grandkids got plenty of gifts today. We cooking all of that. That's just part of who we is. We was taught. I was raised this way. But I know the meaning behind it. And you can't trick me no more. You can't trick me no more. If this is the real reason for the season, everybody go to church next year. Everybody go to church next. That's bullshit. I'm gonna say it. It's bullshit. It ain't the Jesus ain't the reason for the season. Even Christians know that ain't true, because you don't even take your butt to church on Christmas Day. Stop saying that. They got you saying all kinds of stuff that ain't true. It's no truth to that. It's no truth to that. If he was the reason for the season, you wouldn't be in the mall. You'd be at service. If he the reason for the season, what? Everybody would be full of joy, right? Everybody be running around here. La 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 la. It's not true. It's not true. He the reason for the season. When the hell is his birthday? You think it's today? And I just told you Saint Nick get worshipped more and Satan get more worship on December 25th than Christ do. And we quick. This is the day. Where's the proof at? When I get into that teaching in the Bible, we're going to see there's two different ways Jesus came. There's two different ways he died. God knows which one is true. Do you? I know what I'm believing is true. Who? That's why all this baby in the manger and Santa Claus on this day. And that's why the Easter Bunny is in April and March. Oh, damn. That just don't even sound right about your Christ, right? He rose from the dead in March, and then he rose from the dead in April. That's the Roman Catholic Church trying to get their Lent in. And you worship that too. And what I think they do with that Lent, you read your Bible, it say Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of lentil soup. And then the Roman Catholics, they see when that birthright got sold, they try to tell you they end up with the birth. They ain't end up with no birthright. They stole the word of God. They went in Jerusalem 70 AD, burned down the temple, and took the things of God. It's right there in the book of Romans. Read it. They suppress the truth from you. The Bible says they hold the truth. And it, I got one of them reference translated. They suppress the truth from you. Is that because he going out there telling you he's a poor baby in a manger? When he should be telling you he a king of righteousness and a king of shalom? And the book of Malachi say he coming like a refiner's. It didn't say he coming like no baby. And just because you read in the book of Isaiah, it says a child is given unto you. God calls us all children. Did he say how old the child was going to be? And I know we read it, and I tell God every day, God, if Gabriel came to Mary and Christ came as a little child, have mercy on me. But then I look over here, and it tells me he's after the order of Melchizedek. Gotta look up Melchizedek and see what Melchizedek is, and then you can make a decision. Is he a little baby, or is that the Melchizedek? I'm studying. Because ain't no devil in this world going to tell me I don't know my God. I don't know what God is saying to the people today. Somebody has to set themselves apart. Get sanctified. And that just means set yourself apart from the rest of the nonsense so you can hear God. And when I heard God say Satan is Santa and Santa is Satan, it's enough for me to take this off of my doorpost outside, because only thing supposed to be over your doorpost is the blood of Jesus. And see, when you get caught up in all these other worship and all these different holidays that don't even go with you biblically, scripturally, ain't even for you. You get caught up in law. It's like, hold up. Well, maybe that's why stuff happening around my house and things going down. And you don't know, because you worshiping all these different things, and you purposing your, I'm only going to serve God. And then all these holidays come along and be like, oh my goodness, what's going on? What's going on is Santa get more recognition on the birth of